Do you receive credit memos that decrease what you owe to vendors? If that's the case, then you should watch this video all about credits from vendors. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Vendor credits are when a vendor gives you a decrease for what you owe them for a past service or product that was purchased. The effect is the exact opposite of a bill. So what exactly happened when you entered the original bill? Well, accounts payable went up because you owed the vendor more as a result of receiving that bill, and the specific expense that you were getting the bill for also increased at the moment you recorded entering that bill. So then what happens when you make a vendor credit? Well, it's the exact opposite. Accounts payable goes down because you owe the vendor less, and the specific expense that you got credit for decreases because you have less of that expense, because you paid less, because you just got a credit for that expense. Now, usually the vendor credit is given for a specific unpaid bill, and you would usually apply the credit to that bill at the moment that you pay the rest of the bill. For example, let's imagine on April 11, Rex Repair Shop gave us $300 credit for bill number 8484 that we received back in February. On April 12th, we'll imagine that we paid Rex Repair in full for that bill and used the credit that we got from April 11. So let's take a look at how to record these two transactions. Now, before we enter the bill, you should know that the most important report in this section is the unpaid bills report. And when we take a look at the section of the unpaid bill report, specifically for Rex Repair, we could see that these are the three bills, and this February 13th bill, number 8282, is still open for $700. So now we will record the vendor credit. We click the plus sign. We go over to the column of vendors and we click vendor credit. Now, we know that the vendor is Rex Repair Shop, and we know that the date they gave us credit was April 11, and don't forget to put 2017. Now, it is very, very important that you put the same expense on the credit as what you put on the original bill. With Rex Repair, it's easy. We only have one expense that could possibly be the repair expense, and the amount of the credit, $300. Okay, we will remove the billable check mark and talk about that another time, but right now, this is what your vendor credit window would look like, and you're basically finished recording the credit. Now, at the moment you click save and close, you can come back to the unpaid bills report, and you can see that for Rex Repair, there is now a vendor credit that decreased Rex balance for $300. Now, let's go ahead and record the payment in full of the bill the very next day, April 12th, and you will see how to apply the credit from April 11. So it's very simple. We click the plus sign, we go over to vendors, and we click pay bills. Now we know the date in our little story that we're paying the bill is April 12th of 2017. Now, we know that we have to click this filter button here. Instead of the last 365 days, show all dates, and make sure you only focus on the one vendor you're looking for, Rex Repair. After you apply, you will see that there are three open bills. Now look closely how we apply the credit. If we click once in this box, what QuickBooks Online will do is tell you the total available credit. Now we know we only gave one credit of 300, but that would be the total of all possible credits available. And you have to physically type in the amount of credit you're taking from the total credit available. And if we're taking the total of 300 credit available, that means the payment has to be $400, and this is the amount that will decrease the bank account. After we click Save and Close, when we go back to the unpaid bill report, we see that both the credit and the bill that the credit was applied to both disappeared because the bill was paid and $400 was deducted from cash in bank. Now you may well ask, how does QuickBooks Online apply credits when there are multiple credits available? Well, if there's more than one credit available, QuickBooks Online only shows the total available credit in the pay bills window. If less than the total credits are used in one bill payment, a proportional amount will be applied from each credit. For example, let's imagine on April 13th, Con Edison gave us credit number 8472 for $200 for future use not associated with any past bill. And let's imagine on the very next day, they gave us another credit for $100, and that one also is not directly associated with any past bill. Let's just go ahead and record these two credits, and remember, in New York City, Con Edison is the one that gives us electric expense. So now we click the plus sign. We go to the column of vendors, and we come down again, vendor credit. Now again, this is Con Edison, and Con Edison in New York gives electric expense. And the date this time is April, let me see what's the date here. Yeah, April 13 of 2017. And I think the reference number really should be the number on the credit document that they gave us, 8472. Okay, little reference to Star Trek. Okay, very good. So now the money amount of this credit is $200. So when we fill out this credit and we click Save and Close, we go back to the unpaid bill report. Now we have one vendor credit for Con Edison. Now the other one was on the 14th, 8491, for $100. That should be very easy to record. Vendor credit, April 14th, Con Edison, electric expense, must be the same expense that's on the bill. What is it, 8491 or something, whatever it is. Yes, and the amount of this credit is $100. This credit looks just like the others. Save and close. Now, Con Edison now has two credits, and the reason they are showing up on the unpaid bill report is because they have not yet been applied to any of the unpaid bills. Now, let's imagine on April 15th, we applied $100 of credit, the Con Edison credit that they gave us, specifically to bill number 8181, and you will see what happens. So before we apply $100 credit to bill number 8181, that particular bill is $2,000. So when we finish, that should decrease to $1,900 in the amount that's actually open. And you will see that a proportional amount will be applied from each of these two credits. So we click New and we click Pay Bills, because that's how we normally apply it. We want to filter and make sure we have all dates, but we only need to see Con Edison. Now we know we're applying it to this bill 8181. Now look carefully. This is very, got to make the payment date April 15. And remember, we're in 2017 in our little story. But here's the most interesting point. The most interesting point is that we know we're paying bill 8181. And if we click here, it says 300 available. It does not list the individual credits in their open amounts. It simply says the total available. Now, we are only applying 100 and push tab. And we are not, I repeat, we are not paying the rest of the bill. If you are only applying and you are not paying any of the bill, make the payment amount zero. This way, you don't pay anything on April 15th. You're not changing your bank balance on April 15th. You're not even changing the balance of the vendor. You're simply applying this credit to this bill. Now look what happens when we click Save and Close. We go back to Con Edison and we see that $33 has been taken from this $100 credit and $66.67 has been taken from this credit. In other words, they simply took a third of the first credit, or excuse me, two-thirds of the first credit and two-thirds of the second credit are left over, because $100 of credit is a third of the $300 in total. So I hope you understand how it's taking proportional amounts when you apply the credit. And notice the $2,000 bill has now decreased to $1,900.